All right, so it's just gotten to the point now where I can't anymore. I can't take any more of this bullshit. It's every single year with every single release. It's got a lot to do with this sub-series of games within EA Sports, that being the NHL series. EA Sports is NHL series that I've been playing yearly for many years. And the newest one, NHL 23, I will admit, is better than 22 and is better than 21, and it's better than 19 and 18, and, well, better than 16 and way better than 15. I can't take any more of the broken gameplay, the glitches, the new abilities and the X Factor abilities now that people completely exploit online. It's very, very damaging to somebody that's a competitive player like me. They never touch franchise mode either. That's always been one of my favorite modes because I like to make trades, draft players, yada yada. It's just gotten to a point where I don't think that I am going to buy 24 next year when it comes out. And it's even gotten me to go back to my favorite NHL video game of all time, NHL 2004. And I thought because the occasion was right as well, considering we're talking about a game with an Atlanta Thrashers player, yeah, it's that old. An Atlanta Thrashers player, who are now the Winnipeg Jets, on the cover. I thought that the occasion would be right, and I'd put my own retro, it hurts to say retro Atlanta Thrashers sweater on. And the player, to be specific, is Danny Heatley, who was really turning into a star at this time, hence why he's on the cover of the game. Then the car accident happened, and, well, it did result in one of his teammates getting killed. And the entire city of Atlanta, as well as the Atlanta Thrashers organization, all came together in support of Danny Heatley. And, well, Danny Heatley was so grateful for that he wanted to express his gratitude by saying that he was done with the Atlanta Thrashers organization and that he wanted a trade out of Atlanta. That is why hockey fans don't like Danny Heatley, me being one of those people, for that reason. Despite his skill, his unbelievable talent. But, yeah, anyway, that's for a different video. I wanted to actually talk about why I still play this game over anything that comes out from EA in regards to the NHL series. Why I actually still play this game. And, I mean, a lot of it is nostalgia, because my dad and I would sit and play these games from this era, like, just constantly. The soundtrack, especially on this game, I mean, so if you're a big nostalgia slut like I am, then the soundtrack on these old school sports video games always hit home. And it's always, I have to note, it's always been the EA titles. Not really, back in these days, not the 2K titles or not the whatever. The EA titles of any sports video games, not just NHL, whether it be Madden or NASCAR Chase for the Cup, or it be MVP Baseball, or it be NBA Live. EA just always had the best soundtracks. And to me, EA always had the best gameplay to a certain extent. But, yeah, the soundtrack. You know, I found bands through these games, this era of sports video games, like Chevelle, Deftones, American Head Charge, Bullet for My Valentine, Avenged Sevenfold. You know, those, I guess, were entry-level bands at the time. But they were bands that I loved when I was growing up. But, I mean, now I'm like into death metal and black metal and shit like that. But, you know, it's like a time capsule, man. Like these old school games. And, you know, this specific game, NHL 04, I think is just probably in the top five greatest sports video games ever made. And EA doesn't make games like this anymore. I mean, everything from the gameplay to just the small stuff, like the skating. The skating in this game is better than what it is in NHL 23, a game that's on the Xbox Series X and PS5, and a game on the original Xbox, PS2, and GameCube completely outdoes it in that aspect. And the shooting is the same way. Like, the skating is buttery smooth, the shooting animations are absolutely gorgeous for a 20-year-old game. The hitting is just much better. Of course, this came out at a time where hockey was was a lot more physical. It wasn't as fast paced, but it was more physical. This was back in the dead puck era, where we're in the salary cap era now, and everything's fast moving. The game, like, it's not a big man's game anymore, but in this era, it was the big man's game. And that's just something that happens with time. Like, they don't even play the neutral zone trap anymore. Back in this era, they did, though. And they didn't have the trapezoid behind the net either, so the goaltender could come out of the crease. Can't do that no more. Like I said, they even give you what they advertise on the back of the box. So we've got a lot of advertisements here. So you get the new fight engine at the time was this fight engine, if you guys remember it. It was absolutely phenomenal. That fighting engine is way better than the Fight Night engine that they have. They put in it in 14, and they still have and won't change it up. And it sucks now. It was actually good in NHL 14, and then now I notice every time I have a fight in NHL 23, or even 22 and 21 and 20, it's just very buggy. You never had that problem with this fighting engine in NHL 04. And you get the all-new bruise control, which that almost ended up in the floor. But where you use the analog stick and charge it up and fucking release it, and then, you know, you can pretty much recreate Scott Stevens ending Paul Kariya's career if you so desperately wanted to, which Paul Kariya is kind of a dick anyway, so. And then you also have intense board play. Is that even a thing in NHL 23, board play? Like, I'm just looking at the picture right now, and I'm like, this almost feels non-existent in NHL 23. I don't know what it is. But, yeah, you had intense board play. And then you had fluid, realistic skating, what I was just talking about. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful, realistic skating in NHL 04. And then features that are not pictured, but they're listed. And this is where we get into one of my favorites. Not this, you get hard-hitting NHL action. It's more physical than ever with an all-new fighting system, right analog, bruise control, yada yada, the thing I just talked about. This is my favorite part of NHL 04. Go deep into dynasty mode. Play GM for up to 20 seasons and earn a spot in the GM Hall of Fame as you negotiate contracts, conduct drafts, make trades, deal with free agency, and more. There is not a better franchise mode, dynasty mode in any NHL game like there is in NHL 04. Now, I will admit, the best part of NHL 23 in the past couple of years of NHL games was franchise mode. Okay, I get it. They put in the new trade deadline thing, and then you can see, like, you know, the clock's ticking down, and you can see who's on the block and whatnot, but the problem with that is it bugs out. So, like, I was playing some of my NHL 23 franchise mode, and I think I was using, I was using the Arizona Coyotes, and recently Bo Horvat was traded to the Islanders, and he signed an 8-year extension. Well, that at the trade deadline, I could see that the Islanders were trying to trade off Bo Horvat after just signing him to a fucking extension. It's like, that doesn't happen in real life. Like, nobody does that. It's so fucking dumb. And I don't remember ever running into anything like that at the trade deadline in this game. There were games later on, like, where I would see, like, star players getting traded for star players that would never have happened in real life. But NHL 04, just the dynasty mode, and you could customize your own office as the GM. How fucking cool is that? You can't do that now. You get to deal with players' salaries, even though this was before the salary cap. So this was all budget-based, not salary cap-based, which was really unfair for a lot of the time. in the dead puck era. But they did put a salary cap in eventually, and it kind of fixed a lot of things. But still, like, you just go in, sign free agents, give them what they want, and then if you're like me, I'd go in like year one and go sign some of the older free agents and then just start trading them for draft picks. Like, that's what I would do. And then I use those draft picks at the deadline to package them up and get, like, star players just left and right. You know, I cheese the system. I wouldn't do that now if I was to start it now. But when I was a kid, that's what I'd do. I'd start up a franchise. I'd go in, sign Joe Nieuwendyk, sign Cliff Ronning, sign Adam Oates, sign Mark Messier, and then just trade them all away for draft picks. And then package draft picks with... Or I would package the draft picks and try to trade for, like, star players, which I don't understand why I didn't just trade the freaking free agents for star players, but I was stupid, I guess, at that time, and I wasn't thinking that far ahead. But, no, it's just, there's just a lot of, like, fun memories associated with this game. Me and my dad just sat there playing it all the fucking time. He'd always beat me, and just really, really, really good memories. I'd pull out a win every once in a while, but yeah, my dad always kicked my ass. He always played with Toronto, so, you know, that wasn't fair because Toronto was actually good in this year. And I mean, they're good now, obviously, but there's a time where they weren't. But it's just that there's nothing. Anytime I want to play an NHL video game, this is the one I always grab off my shelf. I don't ever pick up 23 because I want to play it. Or same with the recent, like, through the years when 20 and 21 and 22 were the newest games. Like, I'd play them and I'd maybe play them online or something like that. And I think what really pisses me off about those is they keep adding features that were already in these older games, by the way. Like these certain types of deking and the batted goals and whatnot. But the thing is that now they're totally exploitable. And the toxic players online constantly exploit the X factors and the deking and the certain abilities and whatnot. Like, they just constantly exploit the game, and it's just really toxic. But you didn't have that bullshit in these games. No, you can't play this online nowadays, but, you know, you can still, there's couch play, which used to be a thing when I was growing up. That's not really a thing that exists now. You know, we used to actually sit in the same room and bond over video games versus sat talking over a microphone. But regardless, this is still, I think, probably the best NHL video game. Probably the best, my favorite, personal favorite sports video game of all time. I wouldn't say it's the best sports video game, like, ever made, but it's my personal favorite. So, these old school games, man, I swear. I just wanted to talk about it for a second because I've given up playing NHL 23, and I'm going back to this game because... This is the one I always go back to. Every single year, the newest NHL video game comes out. I play it for like 2 weeks, and then I go back to this. I mean, this game obviously did something right. And I'm not the only one, either. There's a lot of people that have gone back to this, or 06. Some people go back to 14, which 14 was a good one. I like that one. But yeah, this and 05 and 06, 14, 09. A lot of people are going back to those games because they're just sick of the way that EA treats hockey fans. Broken gameplay. Graphics look stellar. I mean, I got it on Series X. NHL 23 on Series X. Graphics looked absolutely unbelievable. Every stitch, every thread, and all the sweaters are visible. But that doesn't mean anything if the gameplay is shit. And I'm sorry, the gameplay to me is not good. It hasn't been good since 15. Okay, the last time I remember an NHL video game actually having good gameplay was 14. So, what happened is instead of building upon what they created throughout the years, like they had, they built upon this engine with 04. Because 03, I mean, I remember that game. I didn't play it a whole lot. It wasn't that great. This one was the game that they really hit home, and then they kept building on it, and then they kept building on it, and then they had the transition from the sixth gen to the seventh gen, I think, if I've got my generations correct there, to the PS3, 360, yada yada. Then they kind of started something new, and then they built upon it, and built, and built, and built, and instead of building upon it more when the PS4 and Xbox One came out, they just tore everything down with 15. Like, 15, it's not that 15 was like a terrible, terrible game. It's just there was nothing in it. like the franchise mode was bare. They took out season mode. They were focusing more. They're more focused nowadays on Ultimate Team. So they didn't continue to build upon what they established. They stripped it down and then tried to rebuild it. But they don't do that anymore. Now they just focus on Ultimate Team and they keep giving the offline players the same game over and over and over. And it's just to a point where I don't want to. I knew I was going to drop it at some point. I don't want to continue to shell out $60 for the same shit when this game is far beyond anything that EA has put out in the last 15 fucking years. Well, I shouldn't say last 15 years, but maybe the last 10, 11, maybe more accurately 6 or 7 years. No, I think I'll just always find myself playing this no matter what year it is. The rosters, man, like even the rosters were just like this was when I started getting into hockey. I wasn't there for the 80s, I wasn't there for the 70s, I wasn't there for the 90s. People say, "Oh, those were the best years." I mean, I guess, but I think this was when it comes to physicality and brutality and how violent the sport was. This was the time to be a hockey fan, in my opinion. That's just my personal opinion, though. Oh, I just am really fed up of EA giving us the same shitty games. Changing nothing. They're always broken. They're never finished. For us franchise mode players, there's just like horrible logic when the computer players make trades with each other. Like, you'll have like a rebuilding team trade away like a top prospect for like a washed up 35-year-old fucking player. It's just that's not how it works in real life. And if it does, if there is a GM that does that in real life, they probably need to be fired on the spot. But that's neither here nor there. So it just pisses me off that it's lazy every single year. But they weren't lazy. They weren't that lazy when they were making this game. That's what pisses me off the most. There didn't seem like any laziness was involved in making this one. So that's why I'll always return to this. So I don't know. That's how I feel about EA. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe button, and I'm out. Peace.